Hey guys, so I recorded this video without realizing I didn't have any sound on. That kind of screwed up the whole thing that I had going. Anyway, so this is me after I did my 30 minutes on the bike before I had my shower. And then pretty soon here, the video will start with me actually talking. Hey guys, you know, I am so choked right now. Seriously, just freaking did this video and I get it all like together to edit it and I press play and it's like,
darling, you got to let me know.
Yeah, no sound. I hate when that happens. Ugh. You think I've made enough of these videos right now that I would know. Anyway, my last video, the video I was going to upload, it was crap anyway, so I'm just going to make a few notes here, and then I will get back to you in a second. Okay, so now I'm ready to give you a proper video where I'm not rambling all over the place because I didn't make notes, and the sound is on. I can see that it's on right there. Okay, so this is week 12. Since I started making my video blogs, I was 193.4 this week, so I was down 1.1 pound from last week. Yay. So my total loss now is at 22.6, and which is awesome, obviously, awesome, 22.6, yay! And I'm down 15 inches. I wanted to talk about, I had set myself like a goal to be at 190 by April the 15th, and obviously I didn't hit that, so I'm hoping in the next 2 weeks, I can hit that. That would be great, because then I can reward myself with a new haircut and a new hair color, which I'm really excited about, so I gotta push to get that reward. So something I want to talk about, I bought myself an iPod this week. It's not like a fancy iPod, it's just a little basic one. It's my little iPod Shuffle, and she's so cute, and she's like a shiny little blue color, and I love her, and I should name her. Maybe Martha would be a good name. This is my Martha, she's my iPod, and I listen to her all the time. The reason why I got the iPod is because my MP3 player I had before, like, totally crapped down on me. So I don't know what the problem is. But yeah, anyway, so that's what happened with that. And also, I wanted to get a new one with a little bit more memory because my friend Martha...
Hey Trish, it's Matt.
...that told me about podfitness, and I wanted to look into that and get some of that going for myself. So I gotta adjust myself. So I checked it out. It's really cool. So right now I'm on a 10-day trial where you can download workouts that you want. You kind of tailor make them to your fitness level, your body type, the kind of workouts you want to do. Like there's strength training, there's stretching, there's running, there's cycling, there's jogging, there's everything. And you can download it. First you make a playlist of your favorite songs on iTunes, and then they put them together so that you're doing your exercise and listen to your own tunes, which is super cool. So I did that. I've got a couple of those. I need to download the cycling one because I broke out the old exercise equipment today that is in my house but I never use, and I feel so guilty about. My kids play on it more than I use it, but I know, it's totally crazy. So yeah, I got the stationary bike out today, and I did it on my own, and I did it for 30 minutes pretty vigorously, but I think I'm going to download like a cycling workout so that I can have a little bit more, you know, I should know when I should be increasing and decreasing the tension on the bike. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I want to talk to you about Biggest Loser. So I watched the finale last night, and the finale was great. You know, I'm glad that Allie won. I knew she was gonna win before I even watched it, so it was kind of, the show was just kind of like, oh, la-di-da, you know. I mean, it was great that she won. She looks amazing, and she seriously worked her ass off for it, and I want to be that girl. I want to be the girl that says, yeah, you know what, I did lose the weight, but I lost it with proper nutrition, I lost it with proper exercise, and taking care of my body. I, you know, I'm not saying that the Biggest Loser isn't a great way to do it. I mean, sure, if I could do the 4 months of eating right and exercising 24 hours a day, totally, I could be there fit and trim. But you know, for the rest of us, it's not as easy to do. It's not, you can't have 15 pound weight loss, you know, and carry on your regular life. I love to watch it because the people inspire me, and I always feel so amazing afterwards. And frankly, that theme song is really, really catchy, and I'd really like to put that on my iPod to listen to while I'm exercising. But yeah, I mean, it's an inspiration. It's, you know, but the rest of us out here that aren't able to get on a 6 month TV show that's going to help us lose 100 pounds, you know, we got to do it slowly, and we have to be okay with 1 pound weight loss a week, or 2 pounds, or 3 pounds, or having it fluctuate, or even gains. We have to be okay with, you know, the small changes that happen within our body. Because, you know, the slower you lose it, the more likely that you are going to keep that off for a longer period of time, and for your life. I mean, if you're going to do it, you might as well do it, you know? Like, I want to be around when my kids grow up, and I want to be around, you know, when they get married and have kids. You know, I don't want to live my life, you know, concerned about heart attacks and concerned about things that I can control in some small way with my weight. So that's why I'm doing this. And I've reached out to Spark, and people have reached back with support and love, and you know, it's so awesome, and I'm so glad for it. You know, I felt bad for, you know, watching The Biggest Loser last night, how they all had to go home, and basically it's almost like starting from scratch. You have to do new routines, you have to figure out how you're going to fit this into your life now, and that can't be easy either, you know, when we've been doing it baby steps from the beginning. So anyway, that's enough about my Biggest Loser rant, but I did join a Biggest Loser challenge on my Done Girls on Spark, and I'm on Team Lavender, and this week our challenge is as many exercise minutes as we can get. So far, since Monday, I'm at like 150 or 175 minutes of exercise, which is awesome, and I'm going to do some more this evening after my kids go to bed. So anyway, I wish you guys all well, and I hope that you had a great week, and I hope that you guys will feel pumped up and ready to go for this week. And I look forward to watching your videos and leaving comments for you, and I look forward to seeing you next week. Okay guys, love ya, bye.